So they are the functions. Coming to the next part, thorax. The second and the middle stagma, which is three segmented, mainly prothorax, mesothorax and metathorax. Mesothorax and metathorax, which bear wings, are called as the pterothorax. The thorax is having three parts: prothorax, mesothorax and metathorax. The mesothorax and metathorax, which bear wings, are called as the pterothorax. Pterio means wing. So the prothorax is not having the wings. The thoracic segments are made up of three sclerites, namely dorsal body plate, tergum or nota, ventral body plate, the sternum, and in between the dorsal and the ventral plates, we have the lateral pleuron. So three sclerites, dorsal sclerite tergum, the ventral plate is called sternum, so tergum, sternum, in between pleuron. Then thoracic nota. Dorsal body plate of each thoracic segment is called as pronotum, mesonotum and metanotum respectively. Pronotum, the sclerite is undivided and saddle shaped in grasshopper and shield like in cockroach. That is a pronotum. The prethoracic notum have three transverse sutures, anticostal, presutural, and the scutellar, and five tergites, acrotergites, prescutum, scutum, scutellum, and postscutellum, thoracic sterna. Ventral body plate of each thoracic segments are called as posternum, mesosternum, and metasternum. Thoracic sterna is made up of segmented plates called as eusternum, and intersterna is called as spinous sternum. Eusternum is made up of presternum, basis sternum, and sternalum. Then thoracic pleura, lateral body wall of thoracic segment between notum and sternum. Sclerites of pleura is pleurite and they fuse to form pleural plate. Pleural plate is divided into episternum and the posterior epimeron by pleural suture. Prethoracic pleuron provides space for articulation of wings and legs. Thoracic appendages are three pairs of legs and two pairs of wings. Two pairs of spiracles are also present in the mesopleuron and metapleuron respectively. Here we can see the notum, the sternum, and in between the lateral plate called pleuron, and can see how the wings are attached in the pleural area. The three parts of the prosternum, then the mesosternum and the metasternum can be seen here also. Then the dorsal, lateral and ventral side can also be seen. In this, the next picture, the different areas of we can see the spiracle, the pronotum, mesonotum, and metanotum also. The propleura, pleural area, the mesopleural area, and the metapleural area can also be seen here. So, coming to abdomen, third and the posterior stigma of insect body. This stigma is made up of 9 to 11 uromial segments and is highly flexible. Abdominal segments are telescopic in nature and are interconnected by a membrane called as conjunctiva. Each abdominal segment is made up of only two sclerites, namely the dorsal body plate tergum and ventral body plate sternum. You can see the different segments of abdomen. Here again we can see the different segments of abdomen from 1 to 10 here. And 10 to 11 segments can also be seen. The number refer terga top and sterna bottom. C sursus, sursi or anal sursus. We can see C in the distal end, you can see alphabet C, which is called as the sursus or sursi. Then E is another segment called as epiproct. P is paraproct. Then S is the spiracle. You can see the openings of the respiratory system. Then the pleural membrane can be seen above the first segment. So pleural membrane, then spiracle of course, then subgenial plate can be
seen SP is subgenial plate, FP and the distillant, and T is the tympanum, the proximal first segment. We can see the tympanum, which is the eardrum, a modified spiracle can be seen. The next diagram, figure 2.8, we have the generalized insect abdomen. Here also we can see the 10 segments and the cerci, the parapropt, then the ovipositor can be seen, then the pleural area can also be seen here in between the tergum and the sternum. Grasshopper, 8 pairs of spiracles are present in first 8 segments in addition to a pair of tympanum in the first segment. 8th and 9th abdominal segment bears a female genital structure and the 9th segment bears a male genital structure. Abdominal appendages in adult insects are genial organs and cerci concerned with reproduction and metabolism. These are the different segments up to 1 to about 11 segments can be seen. The tergum, the first tergum, the first sternum, second tergum, the second sternum, the third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, then we can see the 10th also, and then we can see the epiprop, the 11th segment, the paraprop, then the ovipositor can also be seen in this diagram. The types of insect heads. Based on the inclination of the long axis of the head and the orientation of the mouth part, there are three types of insect head. One is hypognathus. Hypo means below. Gnathus means jaw. This type is called, this is mainly in the orthoptera type. Then orthoptera, an insect belonging to orthoptera, we have the this type of mouth part. The long axis of the head is vertical. The long axis of the head is vertical. That is perpendicular to the body. It is right angles to the long axis of the body. Mouth parts are ventrally placed and project downwards in the case of grasshoppers and cockroaches. They are orthopteroid type of insects. Then prognathus. Pro means front, gnathus means jaw. This type is called as the coleopteran type. The long axis of the head is horizontal. That is all horizontal only. It is in the line with the axis of the body. So the mouth part is also along with the axis of the body. Mouth parts are directed forward and the examples are the ground beetles. So first one is here, this diagram show how the mouth parts are directed downwards. That is, the head will be perpendicular to that of the body. Is the grasshopper's head. This is the hypognathus type of head. Next one is the prognathus type in case of beetles. The mouth parts are along the axis of the body only. So it is prognathus. Then the ultimate thing is opisognathus. Opiso means behind, gnathus means jaw. This is also called as hemipteroid type or the opisorhynchus type. Head is deflexed. Mouth parts are directed backwards and held in between four legs. Example in stingbugs. Many of the bugs, the hemipterans, are having opisognathus head. Here we can see the opisognathus head of a bug. In structure of insect antennae. Antennae are called feelers. They are paired, highly mobile and segmented. Antennae are located between behind the compound eyes. All insects except Protura have a pair of antennae. Antennae are well developed in adults and poorly developed in immature stages. The antennae is set in a socket at the cranium called as antennal socket. Already we have seen this antennal socket. The base of the antennae is connected to the edge of the socket by an articulatory membrane. This permits free movement of antennae. The basal segment is called scape. In the antennae, the basal segment is called scape. It is larger than the succeeding segment. The second annular segment is called pedicel, which immediately follows the scape. Then a mass of sense cells called Johnston's organ is present in the pedicel. So in the pedicel we have the Johnston's organ. It is used as a caudal organ. Some insects like mosquitoes. Both scape and pedicel are provided with intrinsic muscles. The remaining annuli or flagellomeres are known as flagellum or calova. which lack individual muscles. Surface of flagellum is supplied with many sensory receptors that are innervated by the deuterocerebrum of brain. Flagellum may vary in size and form. Function. Antenna is useful to detect chemicals including food and pheromones. Pheromones are chemicals secreted air by opposite sex. It perceives smell. So the function is to perceive the smell of surroundings. Humidity changes, variation temperature, vibration and wind velocity and direction. Antenna is useful to perceive the forward environment and detect danger also. It is useful for hearing in mosquitoes and communication in ants. Rarely it is useful to clasp the mate in fleas and grasp the prey. So different functions. Different types of antennae. First one is the cetaceous, the Brazil-like. Size of the segments decrease from base to the apex. Leafhopper, dragonfly and damselfly. Coming to the filiform type of antennae, thread-like antennae, segments are usually cylindrical, thickened, so the segment remains same throughout, example grasshopper. Then monoliform, beaded antennae, segments are either globular or spherical with prominent constriction in between, example termite, cirrate, saw-like. Segments have short triangular projections on one side, longicorn beetles. Cirrate type of antenna, then unipectinate, comb-like, segments with long pair process on one side, it is called the sawfly. These are the different types of antenna, cetaceous, filiform, monoliform, capitate, lamellate, then flabellate, clavate, geniculate, serrate, bipectinate, plumose, aristate. Bipectinate, segments with long slender lateral process on both sides, it's a double comb-like structure. If it's comb-like structure, then the silkworm, moth, or many moths will be having bipectinate antennae. Then clavate antennae, antennae enlarged gradually towards the tip. Clubbed type of antennae, blister beetle, capitate, knobbed. Terminal segment becomes enlarged suddenly in case of butterfly, that is capitate type of antennae in butterflies and moths. Lamellate, antennal tips is expanded laterally on one side to form a flat plate, lamellicorn beetle. Then aristate, the terminal segment is enlarged, bears conspicuous dorsal bristles called aristate. So housefly is having aristate type of antennae. So aristate, lamellate, cirrate, flabellate, monoliform, geniculate, plumose, pectinate, cetaceous, stylate and clavate. When stylate, the terminal segment bear a stylate-like process, horsefly or rubberfly. Plumose, feathery, segments with long whorls of hairs in mosquitoes. Pilose, antennae is less feathery with few hairs at the junction of flagellum hairs in female mosquitoes. Geniculate, elbowed, cape is long remaining segments or small and are arranged at an angle to the first resembling an elbow joint. This geniculate seen in ants, weevils and honeybees. The different type of antennae can, different insects can be noticed in this diagram. Aristate, lamellate, cirrate, flabellate, monoliform, cetaceous, geniculate, plumose, pectinate, clavate and stylate type of antennae. So this is bipectinate antennae of a moth and plumose antennae of a mosquito.